So today we're on with a project to replace the top steering knuckle of this Frontera. It's a 2001 short wheelbase. So let's have a look. So we've got the wheel off and we have a large block supporting the frame. And when I was doing the brakes, just going through them, about a month ago, I saw all this mess of grease here. I actually made it worse by poking some more grease in through the split in the gaiter. But it's now time to change it. Now the thing here is, it's been on there for 16 years. So what I did was got a can of diesel. Little can of diesel and a paintbrush and brush some diesel onto the threads of the various nuts, and I did this 3 or 4 times over a period of a week or two just to get some soak into the rusty threads. So let's have a look at what we've got to contend with. We've got the 3 bolts on the top, there's another one at the back there, you can just see it. 1, 2, 3, and of course the nuts are underneath just where all the muck is and corrosion, so those have been soaked 2 or 3 times. The diesel just soaks up the threads and whatnot. It works quite well. And behind that lot there is a big nut. It's a castle nut with a split pin, and split pins that have been there for a long time can be a bit of a pain. Let's have a look. So there's the castle nut and I've wire brushed it off, but bear in mind it's been soaked a few times. I don't know whether I can get any closer. Let's try handheld camera. So here we are on handheld wobbly camera. It's been wire brushed off. You can see the tab there of the split pin, and the other half will roll underneath. Don't think we can focus anymore onto the top of the thread, so you need to peel that back. Trying to get these out is a right royal pain, and of course this has been put in the most awkward way because you can't actually get to punch it out from this side because there's this great big lump of steel here. Wish me luck. I think we're going to have to try and get something into the eye of the split pin and lever it through. Again, thank goodness I have soaked this over a period of weeks. I've straightened out the longer tab so they're parallel with each other, and now it's a matter of trying to get to the other side. When you're messing around underneath cars like this, make sure everything's blocked up well so you don't end up with 1.5 tons of car on your chest and nobody around to lift it off, as if there'd be any point at that point anyway. So I've changed the angle of the camera and there we go. I've got a fine pointed screwdriver into the eye of the split pin and it seems to be moving. Whoopee. Was rather difficult because the eye had been pushed down into one of the slots of the castle nut, so you couldn't get anything into the eye for a while. You wanted a really fine pointy thing just to start a bit of movement. Let's see if we can. Get some more movement on this. It seems to be going. I think I need a stronger screwdriver now. That's a bit beefier. Whoopee! I didn't expect it to be this easy. and I would advise you for you not to expect it to be that easy. If you can see there, that pin was well rusty. So at this point, a bit more diesel, and I'm going to leave that for 10 minutes. Having brushed off everything, we get a bit more diesel into that thread, and you know, take your time, because there is no rush at this point. You could have lots of sweating and swearing, or it could be a lot easier. So that seems to be 22 mil. And let's see if we get any movement. Cool. Hey. Success. Isn't that a relief? You've got to be careful here, because that's that ball joint, it sits in here on the taper, and if you do too much battering about, you can loosen the taper, and then there's nothing to stop this from, the threaded section, from twizzling around. So clean everything off, soak everything, and then perhaps it's not quite so difficult. Right, the chassis is supported on a big hefty block, and what we need to do now is release the tension from the suspension. And of course on this one, on these, it's torsion bars. So we'll just lower this suspension a bit to the point where it nearly stops. And we need to straighten this out so we get this whole suspension in line, the hub in line, because we need to break that taper. And the way to do that is belt it with big hammers from both sides, making sure that the flexible brake line is out of the way. So here we go, that's all the way down. Now hopefully I pull the line out of the way, there we go, hopefully my shoulders weren't in the way, we've released the most difficult bit. Undoing, taking the split pin out, undoing the nut, breaking the taper. Now hopefully these three bolts won't fight too much, because if they do, it'll be really disappointing. So we've got one undone with a selection of sockets. And it's typical, that one just fell off. Let's see what happens. And we're using a combination of sockets here. 9/16 and 14 mil, because that's the ones that fit. you look there, there's still some plating, but and that's where the nut was. So that's pretty good. Maybe at this point in time they use some sort of treatment on the bolts, anti-seize treatment, but maybe not. And on with the next one. Well, there we are. Now I've wire brushed everything up, cleaned it up the best I can, and of course what we need to do now is, well, I like to put a liberal coating of grease on things before we even start. I mean, I don't expect to be replacing this again, but if the car lasts that long, maybe the next person, it will do them a favour. So here's the new joint, bit of grease. Why is it blue? Because it's JCB grease, and it's what I've got. So that goes on there like that, and then we put the four, no, and then we put the three bolts in. The new bolts come with the kit, so let's just crack on with that. But grease the bolts and the nuts. Assembly lube, I think they call it. So let's crack on. And with them in place, along with the tradition of Redneck restorations, click. Click. And the last one. Click. And then, now we don't want too much lube in here. Just want a little bit on that, but we want some on the threads. But I'm going to put that on the threads after this has gone together. So now we need to just jack the suspension up a little bit. Hopefully you can see loads of grease on those threads, remembering the person that may or may not come after you. And I'm just winding that nut on. I suppose I really ought to know where the split pin hole is first, so I'm going to take that nut off and investigate. And there it is. That'll do. And there we are, tightened to tight and the split pin put in. And now I'm just going to go around various places, like for instance, I've already done it, that connection there, and I've just put some oil on that because it was quite rusty, and if I want to cut it apart, a bit of oil now soaking for a couple of months would be brilliant.